Hey folks, Kissaki here. Today I have another tutorial for you. Again, we stay within the regime of striking and punching. I think we cover here some most important issues first, and then we go back to the kicks and some acrobatics, perhaps even some weapon techniques. But I want to cover first a big amount of the real basics. So I think that's important, and not leave so big spaces, like, you know, showing one technique here, one technique there, one like this, and there is no continuity. So today I want to show you the chain fist. I think, yeah, it's different from the techniques we already saw in the last videos, because it's not a boxing technique, it's a real kung fu technique. It was very popular by Bruce Lee, I guess. Yeah, it's the chain fist, you know it all, I think. It's nowadays mostly practiced in Wing Chun, and the most central technique in Wing Chun, I guess. Also, you can find it in Shaolin Kung Fu or Choi Li Fu type practice also, so it was practiced there as well. And I think it enters more and more Western styles. I know also from some special units that they use Wing Chun techniques in their close combat styles, because they can use it very well also when they are wearing their heavy armor. We will discuss about fighting in armor. The chain fist. What makes it different? The difference is both hands are equal. So they are on one line in the middle of our body. Our feet, our stance is also different. The feet are also on one line, not like in our boxing stance, our basic fighting stance, one foot in front, the other more behind. You can also do it like this, but usually then you move, you can start with the chain fist, but then you take the foot to the side so that those hands are really equal. And we also do not use the shoulders. The shoulders are just like stiff, so our arms, our fist, they form a triangle with our shoulders. So it's like this, and the fists are rolling. You see, one fist is dropping, the other one is coming up. And we are standing straight. In Kung Fu, they stand usually in Mahdi like this, and they practice it for hours. But also with full speed and more power, of course. But I don't recommend such a deep stance. I will give some theory about this in some other videos. I recommend to stay more, a little higher, a little bit the knees bent, straight to your opponent, and then just tap like the chain. You see? And I also already guessed that you can imagine when this technique is used. It's a devastating technique, you know. When your opponent is attacking you, and then you can do some block movement, perhaps you block like this and that, or just cover it and go in, pam, pam. And when you manage this to come into the inner line, so perhaps you're throwing some kind of cross or hook, and you block it on the outside. Yeah, and then you can come in here. And then you want to give everything. And then you can apply the chain fist. It's a series of very hard punches. Each has the same amount of energy. And really, the amount of punches in the series will weaken your opponent tremendously and will knock him out. You don't give everything with one single punch. You put a lot more energy into all of these series of strikes. And it's devastating. And then you have the opportunity to come in and you see he's open, you have the entrance, you give everything and throw your changes. So, I hope you like my tutorial. It's rather a short one. I have not much more to say to this technique, practice it, go down into Mabu perhaps, and do as long and as hard as you can until your arms get sore. And yeah, as I told you, they use it in Wing Chun. A lot of street fights are just won with this technique and with nothing else. So please practice it. If you like my video, press thumb up, subscribe to my channel to see more of my videos. And yeah, as always, stay awake and always one step ahead. Thanks for watching.